So welcome back to another collection video. This time it's my RPG collection. And when I think about RPGs, I think about Japanese RPGs, you know, turn-based or action-based. But since the Western RPGs have grown in popularity a lot, I'm also including Western RPGs. I'm also including every subgenre of RPG. Like Diablo, for me, is an action hack and slash RPG, so I include it too. The RPG genre is my most favorite genre of all of the gaming genres, and it is represented the biggest in my entire collection. I don't think I have a bigger collection of all other genres than I have with the RPG. I just freakingly love it. I haven't played and completed like all the RPGs, but most of them I did, and I just love collecting and finding RPGs. So without further ado, let's start off with all my collector's editions. We start off with Mimana Ivar Chronicle, Agoras Generation of War 2, still sealed. Agoras Generation of War, these are tactical RPGs, frequently giant, like hundreds of hours. Of course, the incredible Demon Souls Deluxe Edition. We have the Dark Souls Limited Edition. Shin Megami Tensei Persona 2. Tactic Ogres Let Us Cling Together. The original Persona. The incredible E7. East the Oath of Volgana. Trails in the Skies, Legend of Heroes, Trails in the Skies, Fate Extra, and of course, last but definitely not least, Ni no Kuni Wrath of the Witch King, the Wizard Edition. Now for your regular games, Phantasy Star Universe, Grandia 2, Dark Cloud, of course, Final Fantasy X, Final Fantasy 12, Ark Twilight of Spirits, Final Fantasy 10-2, Baroque, Evergrace, Valkyria Profile 2, the incredible Rogue Galaxy. Absolutely love that game. Shin Megami Tensei Lucifer's Call, Champions of Norrath and Champions of Norrath Return to Arms, great hack and slash RPGs. Same goes for Baldur's Gate, Dark Alliance 1 and 2. Shin Megami Tensei Digi Double Saga 1 and 2. Disgaea 1 and 2. The first Disgaea is still my most favorite. Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2, Dark Chronicle, of course Persona 4, Odin Sphere, Suikoden 4, I'm actually playing the Suikoden 2 on the PS3, Hack Infection, Wild Arms 3, and a quite an unusual RPG. It's actually made like a Japanese RPG, but it's a Western RPG, The Lord of the Rings, The Third Age. It's really weird, but it works quite well. For the PS3, there are not that many RPGs out there in the West. They are, of course, coming. I know that Omega Quintet has come out, but I have Final Fantasy, Type-0 HD, a great RPG. If you're like into Final Fantasy and you're thinking, ah, I'm not really sure, it's a PSP game, buy it, it's great. Of course, Bloodborne and Diablo 3, Reaper of Souls. The PSP has an incredible library of RPGs. It's definitely like, the PSP is like an RPG system. Just like the Vita, I didn't have that many Western support, but more than the Vita has. But there are some incredible RPGs for the PSP. One unusual one is a tactical RPG called Dungeons and Dragons Tactics. Valhalla Knights 2. Disgaea Afternoon of Darkness. Yes, yes. Brave Story. Grimson Gem Saga. East the Ark of Nethemon. Nethesim. Generation of Chaos. The Incredible Final Fantasy VII Crisis Core. Whoops. 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 Final Fantasy Tactics. An unusual tactical RPG that I thought was a fighting game. It's a Japanese import, Namco X Capcom. I was thinking at the box art, I'm like, hey, that's a fighting game, but nope. It's an RPG. For PlayStation 2, Xenoblade Saga 2, Legia 2, Eternal Ring. This is actually a From Software game that plays like Kingsfield. So if you've played Kingsfield and you want more, try this game out. Dragon Quest, The Journey of the Cursed King is also coming to your 3DS. Star Ocean, Till the End of Time. I'm at the moment also playing this game. Atelier Eros 2. When Atelier Eros was truly an RPG instead of a mix between RPG and Manakemia. Jade Cocoon 2. Unlimited Saga, like one of the most hated RPGs on the PlayStation 2. Legion, Legend of Excalibur, the Western RPG, and of course, Kingsfield 4. Luckily, my table is really low, so nothing broke. Really stupid that fall. Very annoying. Now, further on with the PSP, Untold Legend, Brotherhood of the Steel, Breath of Fire 3, great game, Igrade Union, Wild Arms, still sealed, Half Mint Hero, a great game, you have to try it out, Tales of Eternia, Sing, Blade Dancer, Generation of Chaos, Eadis Eclipse, really great name, Star Ocean, First Departure, or Second, yeah, First Departure, I still need Second, Astonisha Story, and if I remember correctly, this is also a Korean-made RPG, and Grimson Gem Saga is like a sequel to this game, if I remember correctly. Tales of the World, Radiant Mythology, Jeanne d'Arc, tactical RPG, of course the incredible Final Fantasy and Final Fantasy 2. You need to have this in your collection if you're an RPG fan, of course. And if you never played an RPG, the PSP versions are definitely like RPGs that makes you see what an RPG is, even though they're really outdated. Dungeon Siege, Throne of Agony, Kingdom Hearts, what is this, Birth by Sleep? Yes, still sealed, never played it. Valkyria Profile 2, yes, I supported this and I bought it as launch. So don't hate me that they never released Valkyria Profile 3 here because of the sale, because I supported it. Final Fantasy 4 and Final Fantasy 4 the FTS is like the complete edition. Jikandia, RPG that I haven't played. Nights in the Nightmare. Phantom Brave. Gun Gear. Hexiforce. ZHP Unlosing Ranger VS Dark Death Evil Man. Holy shit. The Incredible Rare Class of Heroes 2. Blazing Souls. White Knight Chronicle Origins and Growlancer Heritage of War. White Knight Chronicles is more like a hunter game. Kind of plays like Phantasy Star on the PSP. Now for the PS Vita, I know that the PS Vita is like, it's a niche, whatever you want to call it, RPG handheld system. But for some weird reason, I really don't have that many RPGs on the system, maybe because it's still a little bit expensive and my budget is just set to more like the PS4 games at the moment and some of the PS3 games. And I'm waiting for price drops and bargains for the Vita games. So of course I did support Ease, of course, Ease Memories of Celceta. Great, great action RPG, you have to buy it. Tales of Hearts R, it's still sealed. And now you're thinking, but Thoughtkiller, you are such a big Tales of fan. Yes, I am a big Tales of fan. And finally, the price drops for the PlayStation TV. It was like 100 euros, now it's only 50 euros. So hopefully at the end of the month, I will finally have my PlayStation TV and I can play this game. Etc., a Japanese import, a traditional RPG, minus the gay kissing. Yeah, it's a bit weird, but whatever. The American version of Chrono Cross. The original Kingsfield. Mm-hmm. Great game. Oh, the game. Of course. Final Fantasy IX. Final Fantasy VIII. The incredible that made me such a huge Final Fantasy fan and a huge RPG fan. The first RPG I've ever played. Final Fantasy VII. Final Fantasy VI that I bought at launch. Never played it. Only bought it for the Final Fantasy X demo. But I am, like a couple of months ago, I started playing Final Fantasy. I called it Operation Complete Final Fantasy VI. And if you want an update, no, I haven't played it for a long, long time because I'm playing like Star Ocean and Suikoden. And right now, at the moment, I am playing Wolfenstein, the Old Blood. Of course, physical edition. The game's great. The incredible Diablo. I'm not actually sure if this is an RPG, but Little Big Adventure, and it looks like an RPG, so I'm not really sure. I never played it. Grandia, still sealed. Wild Arms. The Grand Stream Saga. This is a really old game, that's why it's like broken and the box art is gone. It's Blaze and Blades, a really cool action RPG with a shitload of customization and a huge amount of playable classes. The incredible Breath of Fire 3. Vagrant Story, Legend of Cartia, Alundra, Star Ocean, I think the second story, Breath of Fire 4, and Front Mission 3. The only Front Mission game I ever played was Evolved on the PS3, and that's more like an Armored Core game. Now on to the PS3. And it's quite funny that a lot of gamers think that the PS3 doesn't have that many RPGs, and well, the PS3 does have a lot of RPGs. The difference is, it doesn't have a lot of quality RPGs, and it's more like the mood type of games, you know, and the big boobs, and more like fan service games than true RPGs like Breath of Fire, but still, the PS3 has some good ones. Just like Eterna Sonata, Agarus, Generation of War, Cross Edge, Final Fantasy F, good RPG, also coming to the PS4. The Witch and the 100 Knights, don't buy this game. There is a revival, or pretty much a remastered version of this game coming out for the PS4, and the second one is also in development for the PS4. Time and Eternity, I know a lot of websites and gamers are hating on this game, but if you're a huge RPG fan, go play it. It's actually quite a lot of fun. And you know what? I actually completed it. That's how much I enjoyed the game. And the art design and artwork is absolutely fantastic. The Guided Fate Paradox. The incredible rare, again, Clash of Heroes 2G. Ragnarok Odyssey Ace. Tales of Axillia 2 and Tales of Axillia, great RPGs. White Knight Chronicles 2, also highly favorite. White Knight Chronicles. 3D Dot Gaming Heroes, pretty much the Zelda for the PS3. Disgaea 4. Atelier Ayesha. Atelier Meruri, yeah, Meruri, weird name. Atelier Tatori. And Atelier Verona, no, they're not the plus versions. I will get them when they're like 10 euros or something. because they're pretty much the same game. Hyperdimension Neptunia Victory, Hyperdimension Neptunia Mark II, and Hyperdimension Neptunia. It's actually quite a funny story. When this game got announced, pretty much everyone was like, oh, this is not coming out to the West and this and that. And now, like years later, Hyperdimension is like, holy shit, a giant ass franchise with a lot of games for the PS Vita. Trinity Universe, a great RPG. Arno Search Plus coming out for the PS Vita. But it's only digital. Oh, no, there is a limited edition, physical edition. And it's a great game. Archneiko Koga. Trinity Souls of Zil-Ul, an incredible, seriously incredible action RPG from Tecmo Koei. Yes, and they're actually making another action-based RPG for the PS4. I can, and PS3 and PS Vita. I can't freaking wait. This game is absolutely fantastic. Mugen Souls, well, Ni no Kuni, and the artwork is amazing, but the game is bad. Last Rebellion, but the artwork is amazing. One of the biggest and most fun Western RPG that I have played on the PS3 with an incredible battle system, Kingdom of Amalur: Reckoning, great game. Of course, the incredible Skyrim, Dungeon Siege 3, Rune Factory, Tides of War, yeah, Tides of Destiny. It's still like an RPG that I'm like looking at and like, it looks interesting, but when I actually played it, it got bored really fast. Tales of Brixf, Tales of Symphonia Chronicled has Tales of Symphonia 1 and pretty much the sequel. Final Fantasy 13 2, still sealed, don't play, don't care. Final Fantasy 13, don't care. Star Ocean Last Hope, great game, and of course the new Star Ocean is coming out. Dragon Age 2, the incredible Dragon Age. Dark Souls 2, Dark Souls Prepare to Die Edition, the physical edition, and I already had Dark Souls. The incredible Valkyria Profile. Disgaea 3. Folklore, also a great RPG. And last but definitely not least, a beautiful looking, clumsy playing, but still a lot of fun, co-op 2D brawler RPG, Dragon's Crown. Ooh, holy shit. So these are all my RPGs, you know, Japanese RPGs, technical RPGs, hack and slash RPGs, Russian RPGs that I have in my entire collection. I hope you enjoyed it. Definitely leave it in the comments below. What is your collection of RPGs and what is your favorite genre of RPGs? Just a traditional turn-based Final Fantasy games, or more like the action-based East games, or you're like super interested in Final Fantasy 15 because I've seen some gameplay and I am interested in Final Fantasy 15. I have a feeling that Final Fantasy 15 is going to be the Final Fantasy that everyone wanted in Final Fantasy 13. And yeah, it looks incredible, so I can't freaking wait. And I know The Witcher 3, everybody's talking about The Witcher 3. I am still like thinking, should I buy it at launch? Should I not buy it at launch? The reviews are saying I have to buy it at launch, but I'm not really sure. I'm playing so many games, but The Witcher 3 is definitely a game I would recommend buying. So I hope you enjoyed this little video, and like always, you will see me next time.